Thank you. What do you see? a Christ religious background, and so on. We don't require a deity or any kind of religion to give us those things, but we come with them as part of our species. And for me, it's not so much that science can answer moral questions, but science certainly can guide us in a lot of ways, especially when moral questions are in conflict with realities we've now learned it.
gravitational magnetic field. of philosophy based on the acquisition of extreme experience. Behind the back of the ground function, you know, they are.
our most intractable challenges. Not merely to cure disease, but to end poverty and hunger. To heal the planet. And build a better future for all of us. New type of thinking is essential if mankind is to survive and move toward higher levels.
Thank you. we want to expand the dosage levels broader, deeper into the cosmos. Levels.
yourself frequency and vibration. The one thing we all have in common, we connect with it instantly. Turn on any fast-paced song around a two-year-old, and they can't help but to dance to the beat. We instinctively understand the vibrational connection of all things through sound.
audio that creates the same chemical reaction in your brain as drugs.
collective paranoia. People depending on each other's errors to control and exploit. Now and then we even communicate with one another. What does it mean for companies to know everything about us? And for computer algorithms to make life and death decisions? We like to think we have some form of control still, making our constant binary choices and voicing our equally shallow opinions, more loudly or quietly. Most people can't even decide what color to wear or which burger to eat. What the fuck does it matter? Autonomy is an illusion. Pull over our eyes and shove down our throats. Errors force the system to adapt, to develop, that's the link to the new paradigm. A new version emerges. Inescapable progress. I'm not crazy. Am I?
Sources of distraction.